In this lesson, I'll show you how to create an Amazon DynamoDB table, and we're going to load some data into it using the command line interface, and then we're going to practice with the query and scan APIs using the CLI, and I'll show you around the console as well. So let's head over to DynamoDB. Just search for DynamoDB. Here it is, a managed NoSQL database. And what we're going to do is we're going to create our first table. So the database actually exists with DynamoDB. What we're doing is creating tables within it. So all we need to do here is click on Create Table. In the course download, you'll find the Amazon DynamoDB directory, and within that, the Create Table Add Data Markdown file. So here, it tells us what we need to put into the settings for our table. Firstly, we need to set the table name to My Orders. And it is important that you follow these instructions. So I'm going to paste the table name in, My Orders. Then we're going to specify the partition key and the sort key. So this is part of the primary key. The partition key is a unique value, has to be unique for every item in the table, and it can be used for retrieving our items. We'll see how to use it later on when we search for our data. And then we have the optional sort key as well. So let's come back and find the primary key, which is going to be client ID. We'll put that in. And then the last one is the sort key, which is created. Now, those are the only settings that I need to specify. I could change some of the other settings, like I can specify the table class that I want to use, for example, infrequently accessed or standard. You can choose the capacity mode. So how do you want to essentially set the amount of throughput that you require, the amount of operations that you can perform against your table. And there's even a capacity calculator here to help you to understand the impact of the settings that you apply. Now I'm just going to leave it on the default settings and then scroll down and create my table. These tables are really fast, not like RDS where you're waiting for 10 minutes. This should be ready in literally a few seconds. So now I have my table ready. In the same folder in the course download, you'll find this batch-write.json. What you'll find in here is we have a series of individual items that are going to be added to our table. So we have the My Orders table specified, and then we can see we have a put request and an item. So there's 20 different items in this document. Each one has the client ID as an email address, so that's a unique value associated with each of the customers. Then the created is used as well. That's the created, so it's basically a timestamp. And we have the SKU. We have the category, so electronics for this one, and so on. And you can see that they're either string values or number values in this case. This file needs to be uploaded to AWS Cloud Shell. So I'm going to come back and just open up Cloud Shell. And in Cloud Shell, once this is ready, I'm going to upload my document so that we can run a CLI command to actually load all of the information into our table. So let's click on Actions, Upload File, and I'm going to select my batch-write.json. And now the file's uploaded. Let's just check it's there. I've got my file ready for the command. Back in the Create Table Add Data document, here it tells us to upload the file. We've just done that. And then we can use this CLI command. So we're going to use the batch-write-item. It means that one operation is going to actually write all 20 of these items to our table. So I can come back, put in the command, press enter, and it should come back with unprocessed items and there's no response in there. So that's good. It means everything was processed. Back in the DynamoDB console, what we want to do is click on Explore Items, select My Orders. And now we can see that we have 20 items returned. So we've got all of these different items in our table. Now, by the way, I mentioned before that the client ID, which was the primary key, needs to be unique. Well, of course, people might place multiple orders. When you have client ID and a sort key created, it's actually the combination of these two together that need to be unique in the table. So in this case, for example, client 4 could purchase multiple items because the date stamp and the time stamp is likely to be different. Therefore, it constitutes a unique value in the table. So here we can now see that we have all of these different items in our table. Now you can see that it says here the read capacity units consumed were 0.5. So we have read capacity units and write capacity units. That's how we allocate the amount of performance on our table and how many operations we can perform. And it's how we're actually charged. So here we've got scan and query. What just happened was a scan. You can also filter by things like specific attributes. So you can then filter down by the attributes that you're interested in. And then there's also the query API as well. The query API queries the whole table, and then we can filter the results. What we're going to do is see how we can actually scan and query from the CLI. So back in the document here, we're going to go down to section 3 or number item 3, use scan APIs to find data. So this first example is going to demonstrate how to scan the MyOrders table for items in a specific category, in this case, electronics. And of course, you could change that to one of the other categories as well. So I'm just going to copy this command, which is this line here from 25 to 28. Let's go back to Cloud Shell, confirm that I want to paste this in. And that's a single command. Let's run that command. And then we get some responses. And if I press the space bar, I can just filter through those responses and then Q to exit. So that's a scan. Next, this example shows you how to scan the table for items where the quantity is greater than 2. So let's see how many of those we have. I'll come back, I'll clear my screen so you can see better. Let's paste this in and press enter. Okay, so now I've got one item there, a couple of items, and we can see finally we get a count and it says 3. So it scanned 20 items and 3 of them fit my search criteria. Next up, we have the query APIs. So we can see this one here is looking for orders made by a specific client identified by the client ID. So I can copy these lines here. We're running query now, whereas before we were running scan. Again, we're specifying the table name. We've got a condition expression, which is client ID equals client ID. And then under here, we've specified the specific client ID. So let's clear my screen again, paste this in, press enter, and we can see that we get some responses back. In this case, just one. We can also see it only scanned one item because of the filter that we had in place. So let's quit out of there and then come down to the final one. This one is looking for orders from a specific client within a certain date range using the sort key along with the partition key. So here we've got some timestamps. So we're actually searching for orders made in a specific time period. So let's paste that one in, press enter, and we get some results. Again, count one, scan count one. So only one order actually matched that criteria. So that's a little bit about DynamoDB. If we come back into the main console here, there's quite a few other items I can show you. So let's go across to indexes. These are ways that you can perform queries on attributes that are not part of the primary key of the main table. So we can create these things called global secondary indexes. We've got some monitoring here. We've got global tables, which is the multi-region, multi-master table where we can actually have multiple copies of the same table in different regions and we can read and write in those different regions. We can set up backups here, point in time recovery, which is off at this point in time. We can always change that. We can also take manual backups when we need to. We can set up streams here. You can create a DynamoDB stream so that every item level change that's made in your table can be recorded and placed into the stream for processing, for example, by a Lambda function. You can export to S3. You can also place information into Kinesis instead of DynamoDB as well. And then finally, there's a few more settings here in terms of adjusting stuff like your table capacity if you need to scale your DynamoDB performance. So that's everything I'm going to show in this particular lesson. Let's come back up and I'm finished with this table. So I'm just going to go ahead and delete it. And I don't want to create an on-demand backup, so I'm simply going to confirm and that will delete my table.